So we're here with partner and managing director of the San Francisco office, Jeremiah Johnson. Attorney Jeremiah, how are you?
Doing great. How are you doing?
I'm very good. Okay, so today let's talk about deportation. What exactly is deportation?
Well, deportation is the process of removing a non-U.S. citizen, an alien, or an immigrant from the United States. It's a process that starts with Immigration Service putting you in front of an immigration court or an immigration judge. And they do that by giving you a piece of paper called a notice to appear. Okay, once you get that paper, it explains why they're trying to deport you or remove you. There's a number of reasons why the government may want to try to remove someone from the United States or deport them. Sometimes criminal activity, sometimes misrepresentations or fraud or lies to the Immigration Service that may have occurred many, many years ago. Other times people just simply overstay their visa, and that process of removing them from the United States is what we call deportation.
What do immigrants do when this comes up? Do they have a right to an attorney or?
Well, yeah, they do have a right to an attorney, but they have to pay for their own attorney. Unlike criminal proceedings where you have a right to an attorney and they would provide one for you, here you have to pay for your own attorney. And what the attorney does in immigration court is they'll have to respond to these charges that we talked about in the notice to appear. The person may not even be removable for committing a crime. He may not have committed the crime, or he may not have misrepresented himself or lied to get that visa, or maybe he did and that there's some sort of relief available. So the attorney would present all the documents and evidence in front of a judge to convince that judge why this person should stay in the United States. And that's something we do here at Reeves & Associates. We have attorneys that practice exclusively in immigration law, and even some of our attorneys were previous employees of the immigration courts. So we're not only representing them in consular processing or other avenues, in deportation is one of our strong points here.
So what kind of attorney then are you? Do you specialize in this field, or is that all the attorneys at Reeves & Associates?
Well, all the attorneys in Reeves & Associates are capable of doing immigration. They're all immigration experts. Mm-hmm. But I particularly, at my office in San Francisco, I do represent immigrants in deportation proceedings. I also represent immigrants in the immigration courts throughout the country. So I've been to New Jersey and Florida and Texas, and you know, we represent them all over the country. And so we do it all, you know, here at Reeves & Associates.
Mm-hmm. So what would you say are the type of forms or precautions you can go into to, let's say, so I don't want to be deported. What would I go do? What would be the proper process?
Well, yeah, if you don't want to be deported, you're going to find yourself in front of an immigration judge. Then if you don't want to be deported, you're going to want to go talk to an attorney, because the government is going to be represented by an attorney, and the government is going to try to prove and establish how you can be deported and why you should be deported. So the government's going to have an attorney, and we think it's a good idea that you then have an attorney. Mm-hmm. Then depending on what you're being deported for, whether you lied to get your visa, or whether you committed a crime, or whether you just overstayed a visa, that determines what you're going to do. A lot of our cases, or an example of a case that comes up quite often here, is that someone may have lied to get their initial visa. And years later, it comes up that maybe they want to become a citizen or petition their family back home in the Philippines. And then this lie is stopping them, and they find themselves being removed from an earlier lie.
Okay. So it sounds like there's so many different cases involving deportation. What are some of the different types of waivers that go with these different cases?
Sure. Well, a waiver is generally saying, yes, you can deport me from the United States or remove me, but I want to waive that problem. And so one of the ones that we work with are what we call a 237A1H waiver. Now, that sounds complicated, you know, all these numbers and letters, but it's just referencing to what section of the law. Mm-hmm. And 237A1H is a waiver for someone who lied when they entered the United States, and yet they can stay here and ask, and the judge is going to balance their good points for their bad points. For example, you have a misrepresentation that comes up a lot, is that a child or an adult son or daughter of an immigrant is petitioned, and they have to wait like 10 or 15 years to come to the United States, and it's really difficult to put your life on hold for those 10 or 15 years while waiting. So some get married, have children, continue on with their lives. But what happens then is when their visa becomes current, those 15 years later, if they're married, they're not able to come to the United States. And it's really tempting to go into that consulate and just say, well, I never was married, or I don't have any children. And they enter. And that misrepresentation then causes ripples down the line. And they may find themselves 15 years later, you know, wanting to bring their family to the United States or wanting to become a citizen.
Right. So in these type of cases, how important is it to have an attorney? Let's say I were to try it on my own.
It's very important to have an attorney. I can't stress that enough. Besides just, you know, the common sense that you should have an attorney, statistics have shown that most cases in deportation, removal proceedings are denied. However, with an attorney, this likelihood of success is greater. So the government's going to be represented by an attorney. You're going to be in front of a judge. So it's pretty important to have an attorney there at the removal proceedings. There's a lot of technical terms and a lot of requirements that need to be met. But more often, you know, the attorney also knows how to do it a little bit better. Mm. Not just you can look in a book and say, what do I need to present the evidence or what's required, but the attorney is going to know, what is this judge looking for? What is the experience that they have to present a well-documented case? And here in Reeves & Associates, we've been doing this since 1980. You know, so we're going to court day in and day out. So we know the difference between, you know, just presenting a case, you know, or someone getting up there and just saying, well, I shouldn't be removed because I meet all the requirements, versus overwhelming the government and overwhelming the judge. So not only you get the case granted, but the government even decides not to appeal. They just say that this is a good case, this person should stay in the United States. And that's why you should have an attorney.
So it sounds like what you're saying is definitely fight fire with fire, in a way.
I would, exactly.
Today I'll be talking with partner attorney Nancy Miller. How are you today?
I'm good, how are you?
Very good. I've heard something called unlawful presence. What does that mean?
Unlawful presence is what happens when someone is in the United States illegally.